Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we shall be discussing the different temperature scales and also the formulas required for converting the temperature scale from one form to another. As we can see here, we have three glass tubes. All these three glass tubes are identical to each other. That means these have the same height, the same width, and the same volume. These three glass tubes are filled with liquid mercury up to the same level. Here we have two beakers A and B. One of the beaker contains ice and the other beaker contains boiling water. So now we will study how degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit and Kelvin temperature scales are calibrated. We shall immerse all these three glass tubes initially in the boiling water. As we know, when a substance is heated, it expands. So, when these three glass tubes are immersed in boiling water, the mercury in these glass tubes will expand and reach a particular height. Let us say that the mercury in the three glass tube has expanded due to the heat of boiling water and reached up to this particular point. This point will be same for all the three glass tubes as these tubes are identical in nature. Now the degree Celsius scale considered this particular point as 100 degrees Celsius. Whereas on the Fahrenheit scale, this particular point was Kelvin scale assumes this particular point to be 373 Kelvin. In short, we can say that water has boiled at 100 degrees Celsius as per Celsius scale, 212 degrees Fahrenheit as per Fahrenheit scale, and 373 Kelvin as per the Kelvin scale. Now, in the second case, we assume that these three glass tubes are immersed in the beaker A, which contains ice. What happens now is, due to the cold temperature of the ice, the mercury liquid which is in these three glass tubes contracts. So now let us assume that the liquid level, that is the mercury level, has dropped down to this particular point in all the three glass tubes. Since they are identical, these three points will be at the same level. Now the degree Celsius scale assumes this point to be 0 degree Celsius. The Fahrenheit scale assumes this particular point to be 32 degree Fahrenheit. And the Kelvin scale assumes this point to be 273 Kelvin. So now we have three temperature scales, that is, we can say we have three thermometers. One of the thermometer is calibrated in terms of Celsius, the other is in terms of Fahrenheit, and the third one is in terms of Kelvin. So as per Celsius scale, the freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius and the boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius. As per Fahrenheit scale, freezing point of water is 32 degrees Fahrenheit and boiling point is 212 degree Fahrenheit. And as per the Kelvin scale, the freezing point of water is 273 Kelvin and the boiling point is 373 Kelvin. We shall now derive the formula for conversion of the quantities from Celsius to Fahrenheit and vice versa, and from Celsius to Kelvin and vice versa. Up till now, we have studied that when these three glass tubes are immersed in boiling water, then the mercury in these glass tubes rises up to this particular level. And when these three glass tubes are dipped in ice, the mercury level goes down up to this particular level. Now, if you carefully observe, we can see that this length from the minimum or the lowest point up to the highest point is same for all the three tubes. This is because all the three tubes are identical in nature. Now, if we mark this length as L, then this length L will be same for all the three tubes. So again, for the remaining three tubes also, we can mark this length L as L. In terms of temperature, we can write down this length as difference between the highest point and the lowest point. So for the Celsius scale, we can write down L is equal to highest point, that is 100 degrees Celsius, minus lowest point, that is 0 degrees Celsius. For Fahrenheit scale, this length will be same and we can write it as L is equal to highest, that is 212 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 32 degrees Fahrenheit. And same for the Kelvin scale, we can write down 373 Kelvin minus 273 Kelvin. Now let us assume that there is another beaker which contains liquid at a particular unknown temperature. This unknown temperature lies between 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. As soon as we immerse the three glass tubes in the beaker containing the liquid at unknown temperature, the mercury level will rise inside the tube up to a particular point. Let us assume the mercury has increased up to this point in the three tubes. This point will be at the same level since the three tubes are identical in nature. So let us assume that the mercury has risen to a level X in all the three tubes. So the reading shown by Celsius scale, let us assume it to be C. The reading shown by Fahrenheit scale, F. And the readings shown by Kelvin scale is assumed to be K. So similar to the way we have noted down the formula of L, we shall now note down the formula of X. Therefore, X is equal to, for Celsius scale, highest point minus lowest point, that is C minus 0 degrees Celsius. Again, for Fahrenheit scale, X is equal to highest point minus lowest point, that is F minus 32 degree Fahrenheit. And for Kelvin scale, K minus 273 Kelvin, that is highest minus the lowest point. Now we have to take ratio of L by X. L and X we have already derived here. We just have to take ratio of them, or in simple words, we have to just divide these two quantities. So L by X will be equal to, for the Celsius scale we have L is equal to 100 degrees Celsius minus 0 degrees Celsius divided by X is equal to C minus 0 degrees Celsius. This L by X ratio will be same for all the three glass tubes as discussed before, because all of these glass tubes are identical to each other. So we can simply write equal to, from the Fahrenheit formula we have 212 degree Fahrenheit minus 32 degree Fahrenheit divided by X is F minus 32 degree Fahrenheit, and this will be equal to, from the Kelvin scale we have L is equal to 373 Kelvin minus 273 Kelvin divided by X is equal to K minus 273 Kelvin. Now we will simply solve this formula and we obtain L by X is equal to 100 minus 0 will be 100 divided by C minus 0 is C is equal to 212 degree Fahrenheit minus 32 degree Fahrenheit. So 212 minus 32 will be 180 divided by F minus 32 degree Fahrenheit as it is equal to 373 Kelvin minus 273 Kelvin. So we get 100 divided by K minus 273 Kelvin as it is. Now we have obtained this formula, and using this simple formula, by equating the two sides, we can directly obtain conversion from degree Celsius to Fahrenheit and vice versa, or degree Celsius to Kelvin and vice versa. So if at all we have to convert a quantity from Celsius to Fahrenheit, we will simply equate these two terms. So to obtain the formula to convert degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit, we will equate these two terms, and we obtain 100 by C is equal to 180 upon F minus 32. We have simply equated these two terms. On solving further, we can cancel these two. We can also reduce this. And now we can take the C on the right hand side and F minus 32 on the left hand side. So finally we can obtain the formula as C is equal to 5 upon 9 F minus 32. And this is the formula to convert a quantity from Celsius to Fahrenheit or from Fahrenheit to Celsius. This is the formula. In a similar way, if at all we have to convert a quantity from degree Celsius to Kelvin, we simply have to equate the first and the third term in this equation. So by equating the first term, that is 100 upon C, with the third term, that is 100 upon K minus 273 K. So what we can do is we can cancel, and therefore finally we obtain C is equal to K minus 273. So using this formula, we can directly convert a quantity from degree Celsius to Kelvin or from Kelvin to degree Celsius. So these are the two simple formulas, and these are very important if at all we have to convert the temperature scales. It is not necessary to mug up the formula. You can also derive it in this simple method that we have done in this video. I hope you have understood the video. If you like the video, please click on the like button, and for more such videos,